See, managers who want to create high-performing teams need to make this one huge shift on how they approach management. And the shift's quite simple. You need to go from being a manager to thinking of yourself as a coach. So here at Unicorn Labs, we call this the coach approach. Because what we know is that if a manager sees themselves as a coach, they start to act a bit differently. They start to look for opportunities where they can teach, where they can coach, where they can help grow their team. They stop trying to do it for them because they realize that as a coach, you can teach them. You can't get on the court and run the play for the team, but you can develop different plays and strategies for your team to make the decision. See, taking the coach approach allows you to elevate your team by putting them as the priority. So let's break this down. What's the difference between a manager and a coach? See, one of the first differences is that managers reward output. They reward the result, how much things get done. But coaches, they reward effort. And what we've seen time and time again, and through many studies and our own research, is that when we reward output, we create a fixed mentality. Because what happens is that people only do the things they know they can accomplish and that they know that they can do. But when you reward effort, what you're encouraging is a growth mindset, a team that's willing to try and take on problems that they've never done before, but they know that if they try hard and they work at it, that they will be rewarded for their efforts, and that in time, they will come up with really good results. The second point of the difference between managers and coaches is that managers expect very little to no mistakes. But coaches actually encourage experimentation and know that with experimentation, naturally, you're gonna have quite a few mistakes, which encourages your staff and your team to actually have a safe place to take risk, to try to innovate and try to push the margins and fight against the status quo. Step number three, the difference between these two, is managers, well, they consequence when mistakes happen. And coaches, they use that as a teaching opportunity. They use an opportunity, a mistake, as something that didn't go according to plan as an opportunity to coach, to learn, to teach, and to elevate that skill. The fourth thing and difference between managers and coaches is that managers, they're worried about how the team's results and performance looks on them. But coaches instead are more worried about making their team better than them, making each player on the team as somebody who has more skills and knows everything they know and even more. And the last and probably most important piece of the difference between a manager and a coach is that a manager prioritizes the project, the budget, the resources, but a coach prioritizes the people, the team itself. That is the Unicorn Labs coach approach. And that is one of the few secrets that can take your team from average to high performing.